Hey guys, Richard here. Let me turn the fan off in the background. There we go. That's better. Sounds a lot better now. Well, to me it does. Anyway, I want you... Hey guys, Richard here. I just got back from... Well, I just got started filming right now. You can all guess. But take a look at my tires. They're all muddy. The battery's got mud on it. And I switched the receiver position because it's up higher now. But the thing is, I took this truck mudding right in my backyard. In fact, I'm going to show you guys the mudding that I did. And how I got all this mud on the tires. And I'm going to show you guys how to rinse this off. Well, how I rinse my trucks off. And I'm going to show you the mudding part right now. So, okay, here we go. Well, first things first, let me get this track wet. Gotta get some water on it to make it appear like mud. So it's hot outside here in Texas. Because I think it's about 102 degrees now. I'm outside filming in the heat, but I got some shade because of the trees around here. I don't even know if you guys can hear me, but I just said I got some shade out here. Just watering up the little area that I'm going on. Okay, that's good. Okay, here we go. Already got my truck stuck already. There we go. Hold up. The reason why I'm going back and forth, I don't even know if you guys can see it. Let me check the viewfinder. Yeah, the reason why I'm going back and forth is because I like to get a lot of mud on my tires. Now let's back it up. Backing it up real slow. Here we go. Keep going. I have an idea. Watch this. There we go. Let's take this little guy off the camera, off the thing real quick. Yeah, that was about 3 minutes. Take a look at that. That's some thick mud on there. Now, I'm going to do another portion. I'm trying to make this video as fast as I can. I know I'm not showing it that much. This one's in the sun, just a little bit. But I'm gonna wet this and then I'm gonna come right back to you guys, right about now. Okay, here it is, it's all wet and everything. Here we go. I'm gonna drive it forward, back it up, then back it up and drive it forward. You see, I go slow through the water because I don't want, well, now I'm backing up, so now I have to go slow, even though, see, full throttle and it's still going slow. Full throttle backwards and still going slow. But anyway, can't wait to get clean in this. This is the first time. And project 2, I'm hoping should be a mudding truck. Probably gonna use the same chassis or use a metal chassis or something. Let me do the same thing real quick.
Oh yeah, kicking that mud up.
Let me show you this bad boy now.
Ooh.
Yeah, I'm doing good on time. So I thought I said 10 minutes, and I was like, can't make a 10 minute video because I'm not a YouTube partner.
Check out that thick mud. Receiver stayed dry. I'm gonna have to brush that speed control off, brush the motor off and the battery. But, all in all, I'm probably gonna use a different chassis rather than plywood.
Maybe plastic or something, so I can get it water wet and it won't bend. Cause see, right now, chassis bent a little bit because of all the water that's going through now. Anyway, I'm gonna make another video. This is part one. How to drive the, well, not how to drive, but driving through the mud. Part two is how to clean. And click somewhere around here if I decide to put it up, and if I'll. Right here. If I decide to put the video up right there, then it will be up right there. But if I don't, just follow something to wherever. Just go click on my next video to watch how to clean it. And I'm going to clean it right now. Well, that's all for this video. Please rate, comment, like, and subscribe. And if you can, send me a video response. I would very much appreciate that. I always like watching videos about other RC stuff. And that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. And please recommend me to some of your friends, because I can't do this without anybody's help. And thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye. Hey guys, Richardford here. Here to show you how to clean off your RC vehicle after you've been mudding or something. I just take the battery, wipe it off. I'll wipe it off with the damp paper towel later. Anyway, remove these. Remove the receiver. It's the first step. What I like to do, actually unplug the batteries. First step. Get the battery out of the way. Second is remove all the electronics. Make sure there's no dirt on them or anything. Screwdriver. Take out the servo. Make sure I don't lose any screws. And I don't know if you guys can see, I got my buggy in the background with my body modification to it, modifications to it. Keep on getting mud on me because, well, I'm taking off all my electronics, A, because they're not waterproof, and B, if they were waterproof, I'd still take them off, just because that's how I am. I don't like to risk stuff. Now, I could mud without having to worry about my electronics, but I just like to worry. It's the type of person I am. I'm a worrier. Not a warrior, but a worrier. Then, even though they say brushed motors are waterproof, I still don't risk it. Because I don't want to have to go out by a $30 motor. I mean, I guess it could be a good thing to burn out the motor, so I can get a new one, a better one, but I don't have the money to get a better one or a newer one. Well, yeah, not even a new same motor. I don't even have enough money to get the same motor. That's what I mean to say. Anyway, like I had in my last video, I'm using my beadlock tires, CRC stock ones from the Maxstone 10. All my stuff from here is just from the Maxstone 10. Nothing special. So that's removed. Take off those. Now, here's the fun part. I'm going to show you how I like to clean this. A little dirty at the bottom. It's kind of bending. Anyway, here's the washing part with the water. And here we go. I like to start off with the body, just rinse the top off. And my sprayer has a flat rinse section thing. So then I go on to the tires. Move it forward some. Spray the tires again. I know my Velcro is probably going to be all disgusting. Roll all the dirt away. Trying to do this quick before my mom sees me filming while I'm spraying water. Now for the underside. Just a quick spray off like that, and I'll spray off all the parts of my body that got dirty. And there we go. Let it dry out in the sun.
There we go. All clean.
All I have to do, let it dry, put the electronics back on, then I'm done. That's all for this quick video. It's basically the reversal process of what I did. Instead of taking the parts off, I put them back on. So you can just reverse the video or something. Because I don't have time to do the editing, putting it back together. Excuse me. Plus, I like to make quick videos. Now, I guess this was kind of quick. So anyways, rate, comment, like, and subscribe. Recommend me to some of your friends. Can't do this without you guys' help. And another thing. Hold up, let me zoom out. Another thing, the reason why I'm bending over is because I think I'm in the camera view now, is if you know how to make a website with a forum page and everything, please tell me how, because that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to make a website where you can buy and sell, trade and stuff, RCs, and who knows, you make one of my rigs, and hopefully, I know my head's probably not in the video now, hopefully, I'll be able to answer all your questions on my forum once I get the forum page. But that didn't sound good. Oh well, it's alright. Anyway, hopefully I'll be able to make a website for you guys. It's probably going to be richardfordrc.com. Anyway, that's all for this video. Rate, comment, like, and subscribe. And recommend to some of your friends that can't do this without your help. Quick video ending right now.